الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له هاديا مرشدا وأصلي وأسلم وأبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا وإمامنا وأسوتنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأهل بيته والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وإن خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ألا وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, before I started this khutbah, I would just like from all the brothers and sisters, from the bottom of their hearts, to make a sincere dua for our brothers in Halab, in Syria. Allahumma inni as'aluka bismika al-azim al-a'adha. As'aluka bi kulli ismin sammita bihi nafsak. Aw allamtahu ahadan min khalqik. Aw istatarta bihi fi ilmi al-ghaybi indik. Aw anzaltahu fi kitabik. As'aluka ya arham al-rahimin. أن تفرج عن إخواننا في سوريا وفي حلب. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنهم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ليس لهم من معين إلا أنت يا معين، وليس لهم من ناصر إلا أنت يا ناصر، وليس لهم من رحيم إلا أنت يا رحيم. اللهم ارحمهم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ارحم الأطفال يا أرحم الراحمين، والنساء يا أرحم الراحمين، والشيبة والشباب يا أرحم الراحمين. كلهم معينة، كلهم نصيرة. قَدْ تَخَلَّ الْجَمِيعُ عَنْهُمْ. Everybody abandoned him, abandoned them. But you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are the raja, you are the hope, you are the last one and the first one, inshallah. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, definitely, the situation that we are seeing every day on the news and we are listening to, it's not a pleasant situation. And definitely all of us, we may be asking ourselves, how this is going to end. And we got very much depressed. And we have probably all the right to do so. We are a part of it. And I'm not going to talk about that. That is because of our sins, we are being punished in different places of the world. But what I want to bring to all of us is the other picture. Is to bring you what we call the hope. Hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Definitely, there's always a way, and there's always an exit. Once you see it's completely dark, that's the sign that the Fajr is coming soon. In the middle of the night, when you think it's completely dark, definitely what happened after, the light will come. When there's a rope and you tie it so hard, and you keep pulling and pulling, what happened? It will break. And definitely it looks like this is what's going to happen. I will remind myself and my brothers and my sisters also regarding the Quran, how the Quran talks to us. Especially in a beautiful surah called Surah Al-Qasas, which is talks about the surah or the story of Prophet Musa alayhi salam. The surah starts in such a beautiful way, reminding all of us and saying, Inna Fir'auna qad ala fil ard. Indeed, Fir'aun, he exceeded and he passed all the limits. All the limits. And what he said, the Quran, about the people of Bani Israel, he made some of them slaves. And he killed some of them. يُذَبِّحُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ وَيَسْتَحْيِي نِسَاءَهُمْ. He was killing the children like goats because of whatever dream he had. And even their wives, he used to take them, subhanAllah, and abuse them. That was the situation of the people of Bani Israel in the time of Fir'aun. And definitely the people of Banu Israel did not have any solution because their lives was in the hand of Fir'aun, probably. And that's how they used to see it. And they were accepting the situation. They used some of them to give their children to be slaughtered and to give their wives, and they accepted the situation to be the slaves of Fir'aun. There's no way out. If you keep thinking about it, there's no way out how this is going to be solved. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in just a few ayahs, he said, وَنُرِيدُ أَنَّمُنَّ عَلَى الَّذِينَ صُدْعِفُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. And Allah said, I want to favor those that they are being taken and they are being oppressed. ونجعلهم أئمة ونجعلهم الوارثين. Not only that, we'll make out of them the leaders, and we'll make out of them the one that will inherit the power. Subhanallah. Right away, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what he did, what he inspired the mother of Musa. And I want you to think about it. It is the situation which is happening right now in Syria, in Halab. In a lot of children, a lot of young people, men and women, and they don't have no solution. If they stay, they will be buried. And if they go out, they will be killed also. And the same situation was happening to the people of Banu Israel, subhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ. And we said to the mother of Musa, أَنْ أَرْضِعِي. She gave birth to the child, and now she is confused. She doesn't know what to do. The soldiers of Fir'aun definitely will come to her. They will take the child, and they will kill the child. And she doesn't have any power to stop it. And she doesn't have anyone even to help her. If anyone thinks about helping her, that person also will be killed. Not only him, probably all his family. It is exactly what's happening to our brothers also in Syria. Nobody is trying to help them. The people around them, the countries around them, their brothers or the other governments, none of them is trying to help or to do anything. Some of them, they don't even say, إِنَّ هَذَا رَمُنْكَ. They don't even say, this is something bad. Subhanallah. That's exactly what was happening. Allah inspired the mother of Musa and he said to her, أَنْ أَرْضِعِي. Once you give birth to your child, breastfeed him. Subhanallah. This is again another lesson which just talks about the relation between the mother and the child. فَإِذَا خِفْتِ عَلَيْهِ فَأَلْقِهِ فِي الْيَمِّ وَلَا تَخَافِي وَلَا تَحْزَنِي إِنَّا رَدُّوهُ إِلَيْكِ وَجَاعِلُوهُ مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Allah said to her, and don't be sad, and don't be afraid. وَلَا تَخَافِي وَلَا تَحْزَنِي. And don't be afraid, and don't even be sad. إِنَّا رَدُّوهُ إِلَيْكِ وَجَاعِلُوهُ مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Indeed, we are definitely going to bring him back to you. And the mother of Musa, she listened to the command of Allah, and she put that baby in the river, in the water, to go. And I want you to imagine that, how a mother is going to put her baby in the water and just let him go. Subhanallah. And the story is such a beautiful story. Really, that child that's supposed to be saved from Fir'aun, what happened to him? That child, he went again where? To the river, took him to the palace of Fir'aun. And he was being collected by the family of Fir'aun, by the wife of Fir'aun, if you want. It looks like it's not going to work. It's like any kind of movies that you're watching, but this is reality. And we know it's true because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said so. Yes, the mother of the wife of Fir'aun took Musa alayhi salam. And from the very first time that she saw Musa, she just loved that child. قَالَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِ لِي. He is like the coolness of my eyes. She just loved him. Subhanallah. Now Musa, that's supposed to be saved from Fir'aun, he is in the hand of Fir'aun. He is in the hand of the Fir'aun. But Fir'aun cannot put a finger on Musa. Although they said, Fir'aun, he realized that this child is from Banu Israel. For many reasons. But still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that Fir'aun cannot put a finger on Musa alayhi salam. Not only that, Fir'aun, Musa is going to be raised in the house of Fir'aun. In the house of Fir'aun. But I won't, and why I'm bringing this story, to tell you brothers and sisters, we lost faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all the matters. We talk politics a lot for hours and hours. But we don't talk even for a moment to say we do have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That nothing will happen but only with Allah's permission. No one can change your destiny, definitely. And no one have the power to do anything to you, or to me, or to anybody else. If something is written, definitely it's going to happen. My brothers and my sisters, even here in America, I saw a lot of people very, very much depressed. And we look at the faces, especially after the elections, the new elections for the new presidents, and people talking a lot again. And being depressed, and hours, and they forgot something. That your destiny is not in the hand of anybody, but in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we were children, we learned those basic things. Nothing could happen to you, but only with Allah's permission. You know what? Let me bring it to you. As a little small story, again, which is true. Abdullah ibn Abbas, the cousin of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, كنت خلف رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I was riding behind the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Abdullah ibn Abbas at that time was at the age of 8 years old, 9 years old. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, at this age, he wants to teach him something, which is we also need to learn, even if we are this old, subhanAllah. He said, اسمع مني يا غلام. اسمع مني أعلمك كلمات. Listen to me, O young boy. Listen to me, few words. احفظ الله يحفظك احفظ الله تجده اتجاهك. He said, if you protect the hudud of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah definitely will protect you. Oh my brothers, my sisters, whenever we respect the hudud of Allah, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be always there for us to make even people respecting us. But if we don't, we don't have any guarantee. And it's why we are doing it, because of the doing of our hand. He said to him, احفظ الله يحفظك احفظ الله تجد اتجاهك وإذا استعنت فاستعين بالله وإذا سألت فاسأل الله. And if you are asking for help, definitely the only one that you're supposed to ask for help is Allah. And if you need any support, definitely the only one who could provide you with support is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he said to him, وعلم وعلم أن الأمة لو اجتمعوا على أن يضروك بشيء لم يضروك إلا بشيء قد كتبه الله لك. He said to him, remember, and this is a child, a young boy, I'm saying 9 years old probably or 8, still he is putting those things in his heart at this very early age. He said to him, أعلم, and you should definitely know, أن الأمة لو اجتمعوا, if all the nation, all the people together to harm you with something, they cannot, but only with something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already wrote it for you. All of us, we know that's true. But when it comes to the action, we act differently. We definitely act differently. And that belief goes away. And then we start fearing each other. And we start worrying about each other. And he said to him, وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَمْ يَنْفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ. And if all of them, they gather also together to benefit you with something, they cannot, but only with something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already wrote it for you. There's no one who could give you anything. All the people are just wasail, ways, reasons. And Allah, He is the one who put the reasons and cancel the reasons. When they put Ibrahim alayhi salam in the fire didn't burn him. Definitely, although the fire has the nature of burning. But it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who put the asbab, the reasons, subhanAllah. And then what he said to him, وَعَلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَمْ يَنْفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ. And then he said to him, after these few words that all of us we have to understand, and definitely we heard those words many times before, but to put them in our hearts and believe in them and act upon them. And he said, طُوِيَتِ الصُّحُفُ وَجَفَّتِ الْأَقْلَامُ or جَفَّتِ الْأَقْلَامُ وَطُوِيَتِ الصُّحُفُ. The pens are dry and the books are closed. Meaning, the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which has everything, is already closed. Nothing's going to happen to you, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't know about it. And definitely you're not going to eat one more piece of food, more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already prescribed for you. And you cannot earn not even one more dollar or less that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already prescribed for you. We know that this is the basic thing and all of us who believe in it. But when it comes to the action, we become very worried, like this is not the reality. But this is definitely the reality that all of us have to believe in. No one can do anything to you. The Sahaba of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they spent the first 13 years in Mecca learning only this basic thing. Do you know that all the ahkam of Sharia, you're talking about the salat in details and the zakat and the hajj and the sawm and the zawaj and the talaq and all that, it was not prescribed in Mecca, it was prescribed in Medina. And for the first 13 years of Mecca, only one subject, one topic, Rasulullah ﷺ was engraving in the heart of the Sahaba as well. Allah Wahid. He is the only one, and He is the only one who has the power to do everything. And once this topic and this concept was completely in the mind and the heart of the Sahaba, they were able to do the miracles. Because they had that belief. And we lost that belief. And we try anything else and it doesn't work. Do you know why? Because it's very easy. There's no other way but only one way. The way that Rasulullah ﷺ, he prescribed it and he showed us. And that's why in every single salat we recite in Al-Fatiha continuously at least 17 times a day in all our fara'id. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Guide us to the sirat al-mustaqim. That is the path. And in every single salat we say Iyyaka na'budu wa Iyyaka nasta'in. And that's why I mentioned in this hadith also, you are the only one that we worship. Because you are the only one who could help us. He deserves to be worshipped because he is the only one who has the power to help us. It is a duty on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us as long as we also do our duties is to worship him. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. The scholars, they talk about these two ayahs and they say these two ayahs is the whole Quran. These two ayahs is everything it's based on. Your life is based on these two ayahs. You are the only one that we worship because it's a must on you, and you are the only one that we're asking for help because we depend on you. And if we depend on anybody else, it's not going to work. Any other person is going to die. Any other dynasty will finish one day. If you talk or if you think and if you read about the Roman, the Persian, the Muslims empire, they were sometimes and they don't exist anymore. The Muslims ruled in Spain for 800 years. It was a golden time for them. Where are they now? They cannot anymore. Everything finished one day, but only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hayyun la yamut. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of us to have this concept in our hearts. That Allah is the mu'in and Allah is the giver and Allah is the taker and nobody else could do this for you. My brothers and my sisters in Islam, I'm returning back again and saying about our brothers in Syria. And I'm asking you please, and I'm also to myself, every single person, when he is in a moment, when he feels that he is doing something good, ask Allah with that good deed to remove all the masa'ib and the bala' from those brothers and sisters. Definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rahim. Definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Kareem. Definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Jawad. Definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one has the power to remove all those things. I know sometimes we are even stingy to do such thing, to make dua for someone. It looks like it's not really a part of our faith anymore. And even when we talk about the dua, we don't give that importance to the dua. So rather make dua and then make it quick. And probably the dua is supposed to be the shortest one and the easiest one. And probably a person is not, even his mind is not there. He doesn't even know what he is talking about, subhanAllah. That's not the way how to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's not the way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, said, أَمَّن يُجِيبُ الْمُطَّرَ إِلَى دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءُ. Allah said, he or who is the one that you will really help the person who is in a position that he needs help. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we feel in that way, that we need His help, and we cry for that help, definitely He's going to help us. My dear brothers and my sisters, imagine a child, and he's being kicked by his father and or mom. For whatever reason he did. Probably he did something bad, like we do. And then after that, the mother even kicked him out and locked the door. And the child, after he turns around and he doesn't find anywhere, he came back and knocked at the door of his mother. And the mother was a little bit stubborn and she did not open the door. But he keeps knocking the door again and he cries. You think the mother would have some mercy and open the door for him or not? Definitely yes. Allah is more merciful than our mothers and our fathers and anybody. But we don't knock the door. He is the only one who has the power to help and to forgive, and nobody else. My brothers and my sisters, let me also remind you about something. Sometimes when we see things going around in that way, we think there's no way out. But let me share with you this little story also regarding Musa alayhi salam, which is we learned a lot from him. Put this in your heart and in your mind. It says, subhanAllah, that Musa alayhi salam, a woman came to him and asked him, Ya Nabi Allah, who are you, the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help me, to provide me with a child. She was a woman that she couldn't give birth at all for many years. Now she's asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And she went to Musa to ask him that she could ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Musa accepted that request and asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Oh Allah, that woman is asking you for such thing. Oh Allah, help her. And Allah answered to Musa and said to Musa, Ya Musa, inni katabtuha aqima. Oh Musa, I already wrote that woman in my books that she will be aqim. She cannot give birth. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yahabu liman yasha'u dhukura wa yahabu liman yasha'u inath. Some of them he give them boys, some he give them girls, some he give them boys and girls, and some he give them nothing. It's up to him. So he said it's already written in the books that this woman is going to be aqim. But the woman didn't give up. After a couple probably of months or whatever, he came again to Musa and asked him, please ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he did ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah again said to Musa, inni katabtuha aqima. Oh Musa, I already wrote her aqim, she can't. Subhanallah. After probably a couple of years, the woman came to Musa alayhi salam and she was pregnant. And she said to Musa, looks like Allah he accepted my calls and my request. And Musa didn't know what to say. And he never wanted to upset that woman before and tell her that Allah already wrote her aqim. So Musa was very surprised and he asked Allah after, Oh Allah, you told me about that woman. That indeed she will be aqim. قال يا موسى أو موسى إني كتبتها عقيمة. I already wrote her aqim, but she never stopped calling Ya Rahim, Ya Rahim, Ya Rahim. Indeed, my rahmah is bigger than anything that exists. The rahmah of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. Allah has the power to do whatever He wants and to change whatever He wants, and no one can stop Him. Our situation, my brothers and my sisters, if you think that there's no way out and there's no exit and it's impossible, there is nothing called impossible for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you think that your situation is impossible for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are committing a big shirk. Because nothing is impossible for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every single day, what you do, you say, Allahu Akbar, He is bigger. Greater than anything that could be in your mind, than your sins, than your deeds, than your future, than the whole universe. The one who created the whole universe in such a beautiful way, would be hard for him to change the situation of a human being, or of all the human being. Definitely it's not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Hadith Qudsi said something again that I'll remind you. He said to him, If all the people, they gather together and they ask me, all of them, for whatever they want, and I give to all of them whatever they want, would that decrease the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He would not. It's just like a little bird that he came in the ocean and he had a sip of water and he left. That is the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all of us. Astaghfirullah alaykum jameen. الحمد لله وحده ولا يدوم إلا ملكه الصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه When the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم somehow was chased from Mecca He was leaving Mecca And that's mentioned in the end of Surah Al-Qasas And before he left he turned And you look at Mecca And he said, Allahu ya'lamu annaki ahabbu al-bilad ila qalbi. Allah knows that you are the place or the land that I love the most. Lawla anna ahlaki akhrajuni. And indeed, if your people did not try to kick me out, I would never ever left. And he had tears in his eyes. That's the place when he was born. That's the place when he received the wahi and the risala. That's the most beautiful place for him. Such a beautiful place that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the chance to go there again and again. Amen. The wahi came to him, as it's mentioned in the end of the surah. إِنَّ الَّذِي فَرَضَ عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ رَادُّكَ إِلَى مَعَادٍ. Indeed, the one who sent this Quran, this book to you, he will definitely bring you back to this place. This good news, or this ayah, was revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was leaving Mecca. Him and Abu Bakr, and the servant of Abu Bakr. And the people were after him, trying to catch him and kill him. And no one could help him, and no one could support him. And he doesn't have anybody. But the faith in his heart was always there. When he was in the cave, as all of us know that beautiful story, when he was in the cave, and he took all the measures that the people would not catch him, but still the people were able to what? To come and to find the cave. And they were at the door of the cave. This is a little story that we learned before. And we tell that to our kids. That's what's behind it. You do all what you want to do, and you have to do so. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was hiding. Yes, he was hiding. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tried his best to mislead the kuffar. So instead of going north, he went south. Or the opposite. But still, he took all the asbab. But still, the people of the kuffar, the Qurayshis, they were able to come to the door. So he did his part. So he was not worried. So when Abu Bakr said to him, O Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَوْ نَظَرَ أَحَدُهُمْ إِلَىٰ قَدَمَيْهِ لَرْغَالَ. If any of them, he just looked down, he could see us. After all those measures that he took, he said to him, if anyone could just look down, he would see us there in front of the door. What he said to him, يَا أَبَا بَكْرَ مَا ذَنُّكَ بِثْنَيْنِ اللَّهُ ثَالِثُهُمَا. O Abu Bakr, what do you think about two? But Allah is the third with them. If Allah is with you, who do you need more? إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. When he said to his companion, to his friend, don't be sad, Allah is with us. Meaning, we did what Allah told us to do. We did what Allah told us to do. So we did our part. Now it's the part of who? Of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't worry about the parts of Allah. Be worried only about your part. And that's why Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu ardah, he has something very beautiful regarding this matter of dua. He said, إِنِّي لَا أَحْمِلُ هَمَّ الْإِجَابَةِ وَلَكِنِّي أَحْمِلُ هَمَّ الدُّعَاءِ. He said, my worries is not about Allah will be responding to what I ask him for, but I'm worried about me making the dua. Look, who's supposed to do the dua? It is we. And we are muhassirin, we don't do the proper job. So there's the job of Allah, and there's our job. Do you have any doubt that Allah will do His job? No way. No way! But do we have doubt about what we not going to do our job? Definitely yes. It's only our job that we are missing. The last thing that I would like to close with, because we're going to be very honest with ourselves. With the new election that took place, and I just want to touch this in the end, and the people talk a lot about it. What our worries is about? Is it our Islam? Is it about the Islam that we're worried about Islam? Or it's about ourselves? It's about ourselves. So don't make it big. Some people, they want to be heroes. Oh, I am very worried about what will happen to the Islam. Brothers or sisters, that's not your part, that's not your job. It is the job of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْمُشْرِكُونَ وَلَوْ الْكَافِرُونَ. He is the one who sent his messenger with the deen of haqq, that definitely he will make this deen regardless the people like it or they don't like it. And you see Islam is everywhere. Everywhere. Who put the Islam everywhere? Yes, people are wasail, are being used for it. But Allah is the one who makes the Islam. You could be part of it, and you are such a lucky person. You are honored to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is your among them. I'm saying all our worries is only about what? About worldly stuff, about our status. If there's any change, what will happen to my job? What will happen to my status? What will happen to my property? What will happen to my money? What will happen to the future of my children? And you have all the right to be, to have your worries. Nobody will tell you no. But remember, it's all worldly stuff. And remember, those things could change at any moment, whatever precautions you may be taking. Whatever precautions you may be, whatever guarantees you could have from anyone in the world. If Allah wants to change something, He will change it. No one could stop Him. Put that in your heart. Your tawakkul, your trust. على الحي الذي لا يموت. On الحي, that He will never die. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again. اللهم إني أسألك بسمك العظيم الأعظم. الذي إذا دعيت به أجبت وإذا سئلت به أعطيت. أن تجعل القرآن الكريم ربيع قلوبنا وذهاب أحزاننا وجلاء همومنا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لموتانا وموتى جميع المسلمين. اللهم اغفر لموتانا وموتى جميع المسلمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى جميع المسلمين. اللهم اشفهم وعافهم واعف عنهم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم لا ينقضي هذا المحفل إن شاء الله. اللهم يا الله لا ينقضي هذه الجمعة إن شاء الله إلا وقد أذهبت همومنا وأجليت أحزاننا وأجليت أحزاننا. اللهم ارحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ارحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ارحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إخوان المسلمين في كل مكان, في سوريا وفي العراق وفي أفغانستان وفي باكستان وفي جميع أنحاء العالم. اللهم كلهم عونا ونصيرا. اللهم كلهم عونا ونصيرا. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. قوموا من صلاتكم ورحمكم الله وأقم الصلاة.